I'm Scott Crane, and this is Bidding Wars. Today on Bidding Wars, we're looking at this addition remodel project. This house was purchased in 1935 for $5,000. You're not going to find that price anymore, especially in Hollywood. What makes this project really interesting is that this house has never been remodeled. It's been the same since the day it was built back in 1934. Now, what's beautiful about this house is it's a classic mix of Spanish and Art Deco architecture. It's a weird meld, but it works, and it works beautifully. And one family's owned it the whole time, 70 plus years. Wait till you see the inside of this place. Come on. Oh yeah, look at this place, it's huge. The door, there was a guy who used to walk around these neighborhoods in LA with a sheet of metal. He'd charge it $5, $10, I guess. Put the sheet of metal on your door, burn this pattern in with a blowtorch. This house was the model home in the neighborhood back in 35. It was the first house built in the neighborhood. The whole place was surrounded by orange groves. The guy who built these houses made this a little bit bigger, square footage wise, than any of the other houses. It was kind of a bit of a trick. You'd buy your new house, all of a sudden you're like, wait a minute, I can't fit anything in here. Smaller. Good trick. You see a modern house with this? See Tony Stark living here? No way. But this is beautiful stuff. The homeowners, the current homeowners, are really, really married to this style. Who can blame them? This is all wood cut in individually. Every diamond, every little run, took a lot of time. Any contractor or architect who walks into this house with this kind of furniture, the whole way they've laid out this place, the fixtures in here, a contractor and an architect's gonna know they're not gonna wanna deviate from it all in the remodel. They're gonna wanna stick with this style. Look at this thing, this thing's a beast. Solid chrome on the top. They don't make stoves like this anymore. To make matters kind of more interesting for the contractors, architects that eventually are gonna win this job, is that the family, it's a family of three with another baby on the way, they don't wanna move out. Truth be told though, they're gonna save a ton of money this way. In a project like this, you know, personality, experience, references, it's all gonna weigh in, but the truth is, with these homeowners not able to leave the house during construction time, personality's gonna weigh in heavily. I mean, they're gonna be seeing these contractors and workers day in, day out for 6 months. They need to make sure they can get along with them. All right, Team A says they can bring this project in $15,000 under budget, but everyone agrees they're assholes. Team B's friendly and likable, and everyone loves them. Their price, it's right on budget, but the truth is they don't have any real experience. They've got no references. It's hard to trust them. Team C, highly recommended, professional, pretty friendly, but $40,000 over budget. I think that might be a bit of a problem. Which way is this family gonna go? We're gonna find out when we return on Bidding Wars.